Dear students, now we are going to discuss applications of biotechnology in agriculture. And what about achievements? What we achieved out of applications in biotechnology in agriculture? So first one is a bioinsecticide. Bioinsecticide. So as an organic farmer or part of biotechnology, as part of biotechnology in agriculture, we have to replace synthetic pesticides and insecticides as they are having certain number of limitations, drawbacks. They are causing big damage to environment and already they entered into food chain in the form of a toxic material. So there is a need to avoid synthetic artificial pesticides and insecticides. So here bioinsecticide, the given example is BT. BT bacteria. BT is nothing but a bacillus Thuringiensis bacterium, BT. BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis, a prokaryote. Bacillus thuringiensis, a bacterium. So this bacterium is able to produce a protein. That protein is able to kill certain number of insects, pests and insects also. Insects and pests also, but majorly the protein produced by Bacillus thuringiensis is able to kill majorly, maximum extent, able to kill maximum number of insects. Hence the name insecticide. Okay. So what about the description for Bacillus thuringiensis? For example, this is a bacterium. And that is a genophore. The main genetic material of that bacterium. So from this genophore or from the plasmid, it is able to produce one gene is present. What is that gene from that genophore? A gene, what is that gene? Cry gene. Cry gene. A number of kinds of cry genes are there. We will see what are they. So this cry gene codes for, after completion of a transcription and translation, after completion of transcription and translation, What is that one? Gene expression. It's nothing but a gene expression. Or simply protein biosynthesis. So a protein is produced. What is that protein? That protein is cryoprotein. Okay, so whatever the protein produced by that bacterium, initially that is in crystalline form, crystal. So what about state of matter? Protein is a polypeptide. Polypeptide, proteinaceous, polypeptide, polypeptide. So what about the state of matter of that protein? The state of matter of that protein is crystalline, crystal, solid. Crystal, crystalline. So crystal means definitely that is in solid form. So that is the state of matter of a so-called protein. State of matter. And that protein, if it is in crystal form, so that protein, prototoxin actually, that is a prototoxin. Means immature toxin, one type of immature toxin, prototoxin. So that prototoxin. Not able to kill any organism. Not able to kill any organism. Bacillus thuringiensis or some other organism in which it is produced. So here, if it is in crystalline form, non-toxic. If it is converted into a liquid, a solution, definitely it will become very active form. So that is produced by bacterium. Non-toxic to that bacterium, the reason is that is a prototoxin. Prototoxin is in crystal form, solid form, so non-toxic. If it is converted into, for example, that protein at a optimum pH, here pH is a alkaline pH. Alkaline pH more than 7. Alkaline pH. Basic. Alkaline pH. That is more than 7. Okay. 7 is neutral. Less than 7, acidic. So optimum pH required is more than 7. 7 point something, 8, 9, like that. So that is optimum pH. For the conversion of a crystal form of protein, initially, what about the state of matter of that one? Crystal, solid. Okay, so once the alkaline pH is available, what about that protein? Now that protein is converted into liquid phase. So that pH is able to cause solubilization. Solubilization of that protein or prototoxin. Solubilization of a prototoxin. So once it is converted into liquid phase, a solution of that protein. Solution of that protein, cryoprotein. So once it is converted into liquid phase, so here state of matter is a state of matter is in, that is in solution form. You can take a liquid phase. Okay, so if it is in liquid phase, it is able to kill any organism. Now it is a potential toxin. Potential toxin. But in the bacterium, it is not able to cause any disease, non-poisonous to the bacterium. Reason, within the bacterial cells, in bacteria, it is not converted into, protoxin is not converted into potential toxin. Reason, the concerned exact concerned pH is not available. So within the bacterial cell, within bacterial cells, it remains as crystal protein only. So it remains as crystal only. Reason, there is no optimum pH, maybe 7.5, 7.2, exact pH is required. At that exact pH only, the solubilization of a crystal protein into liquid phase is possible. Once it is converted into liquid, it can kill any organism. But here, that prototoxin is not able to kill or not able to damage bacterial cells. The reason is there is no conversion of a crystal into liquid. Because of that, the toxin, prototoxin, remains as a primitive one. Primitive one means not able to cause any disease, not able to damage the bacterial cells. So that's why bacterial cells are in safe side. Okay, so we exploited this knowledge, means a soluble solution of protein. Once the state of matter is changed, this toxin is able to kill. Now it is, once it is converted into a solution form, now it is able to kill any organism. So we exploited that knowledge to prepare a bio insecticide. Now we are using this one as a bioinsecticide. So this potential toxin now, which is in liquid phase, is able to kill pest and insect, but particularly so-called BT genes, cry genes, are more specific for insects, insect group. They are able to kill pest, insect, both. But the major impact on insects. So maximum number of insects are affected by this toxin and less number of pests are affected by this one. So hence the name bioinsecticide. So nowadays we are using this one as biocontrol agent to control the population of a certain number of insects. Okay, right? So there's about a description for a so-called Bacillus thuringiensis. What about that one? A gene, whatever the gene coming from bacterium, that gene is called as a cry gene. That cry gene codes for cry protein. Initially, what about that protein? It is a prototoxin. As it is in solid form, that protein remains in inactive condition. So this protein is inactive condition. But what about the solution of that one? Very active. That is active form of a so-called protein. Okay. So protein basically polypeptide that remains as crystal, solid. So if it is in solid state or crystal form, not able to cause any organism. So that is a prototoxin, not able to cause some disease or something. Once this pH is available, prototoxin, crystal protein, is solubilized, means convert into liquid phase. Once it is converted into liquid phase, now it is able to damage any host. But here, Bacillus thuringiensis is not affected by that protein. The reason is the optimum pH, alkaline pH, is not available in the bacterial cell to convert a prototoxin, crystal form of that one, into liquid phase. But once it is converted into liquid phase, definitely it can kill any organism, not only the targeted one. Okay, so here our target is, with the help of this potential toxin, we are going to control the population of a number of insects and certain number of pests also. So what about the role of this potential toxin? This toxin is able to control population of insects and pests. What are they? So it is a biocontrol agent. What is the biocontrol agent? In food chain, if you go back to food chain, primary producers, plants are the primary producers. Next, primary consumers, secondary consumers, tertiary consumers, various levels are there. So here, according to checks and balance, in food chain, the population is the number of individuals present in each and every species or community is regulated by food chain. In food chain, all organisms are interdependent or not. So naturally, according to natural predation, for example, cat is able to control the population of rats, and a snake population is controlled by some other organism, mangoes, like that, interdependent or not. So like that, with the help of potential toxin, we are going to control the population of insects or pests which are able to damage crop plants. So with the help of this one, genetically, initially, just we sprayed a powder of Bacillus thuringiensis onto the surface of leaves initially. After advancement in biotechnology, we inserted cryogenes. Cryogene was inserted into the genome of certain number of crop plants to control insect population or insects which are damaging the crop plants. Okay, so what are those crop plants? For example, BT cotton, BT corn, BT cotton plants, BT cotton, BT corn, BT tomato, BT potato, BT bean, BT corn also. Okay, so initially, before the advancement or before the advent of biotechnology, we sprayed a so-called Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria onto the surface of the leaves. But after commanding biotechnology, recombinant DNA technology, we inserted cryogenes into concerned crops. What are those crops? Examples. BT cotton, Bacillus thuringiensis cotton, a cotton plant in which a gene of that bacterium codes where cry protein was inserted. So into this cotton plant, into the nucleus of cotton plant, we inserted a gene coming from Bacillus thuringiensis. Here BT means Bacillus thuringiensis gene present in cotton. So this is a hybrid variety developed, okay, developed by means of recombinant DNA technology. So cotton is a dicot plant. Dicot plant. And cotton belongs to Malvaceae family. Malvaceae family. Next, BT, corn. BT corn, maize, mokozana, corn, GI maize, maize. It is a monocot plant. Okay, maize that belongs to Poaceae family. Poaceae family. Next, BT, tomato, family name. This one is a dicot, Solanaceae family. Solanaceae family. Next, BT, potato. BT brinjal also. So many examples are there. Potato, dicot plant. That is also Solanaceae family. BT brinjal also. Next. BT soybean. Dicot. Fabaceae. So all these are the products of, all these are transgenic plants. Transgenic plants. Transgenic plants. Here genetic recombination was in between a gene coming from bacteria and inserted into the genome of all these plants, transgenic plants, genetically modified plants, GMP, genetically modified plants, produced by means of a recombinant DNA technology. Now, go back to cry genes. Cry genes are able to, means a cry protein. Cry protein is able to control what type of insects? Okay, so once we insert that desirable gene, what is that desirable gene? Here, a desirable gene which we inserted into all these plants was a cry gene, a bacterial gene present in the genome of so-called plants. So what is the desirable gene? Desirable gene which we inserted desirable gene from bacterium, that is a Bacillus thuringiensis. Thuringiensis. That was a cry gene. Cry gene. Right, so what are the insects? Insect groups affected by this cry protein. This cry protein, once it is converted into liquid phase, it is able to kill various insects, flies, belongs to various groups given in our textbook. What are they? Lepidopterans. lepidopterons, coleopterons, insect groups, insect group, group of insects, various groups, lepidopterons, coleopterons, dipterons, okay? So lepidopterons, examples, armyworm, okay, cotton bollworm, bollworms, okay, next, beetles, next, various flies. These are the examples for that group. Flies, various flies, and insects, mosquitoes. Mosquitoes. These are the examples. So we targeted these organisms, these by potential cry protein. Cry protein is potentially able to kill insects. Pests belongs to this group. Actually, all these are insect groups only. Okay, right? So here, what is that gene? Cry gene. Cry gene. Three examples given in our textbook. What are they? Cry one. Remember like this. Cry two. Cry one. See? One, two, one. Remember like that. A, C. A, B. A, B. Cry one, A, C. Cry two, A, B. Cry one, A, B. First two, able to control, they can control cotton bollworms. This one is able to control corn stem borers. Okay, we'll see what are they. Cotton bollworm that is able to damage fruits, cotton capsule in the case of cotton. Corn stem borer, able to drill and able to put holes in the stem of a corn plant. So these are certain number of examples for cry genes which we insert into concerned plants. These are the examples. Now, what about the mechanism of action of a cry protein which is produced by either cotton plant, corn plant, or tomato plant? Here I'm taking first one, BT cotton. Most successful hybrid variety produced by means of a recombinant DNA technology was BT cotton. Nowadays, most of the farmers, they have been using BT cotton. You need not to spray concerned insecticides, synthetic insecticides. You need not to spray any so-called synthetic artificial insecticide. Reason it is a bioinsecticide. So cotton plant itself is protected, getting protection from the concerned insect. So here, our objective is not to eliminate, not to kill, not to eradicate all the insects. Our objective is, as an organic farmer, organic farmer, we have to control the population of concerned one. There is no need to eliminate that insect. If all the insects are eliminated, all dragonflies are eliminated, what about the rest of the organisms will be eliminated? So according to food chain, all organisms, so go back to the living world, the beauty of a ecosystem depends on diversity. More is the number of kinds of species, more is the beauty of our ecosystem, more is the dynamic state of ecosystem. For example, one by one organism eliminated, as all these are interdependent, we should not eliminate organisms. That is not required, that is very dangerous. Okay, so conservation of biodiversity is very, very important. Reason, all organisms are interdependent, either directly or indirectly. Elimination of one kind of species leads to what? Elimination of other kind of species, which is dependent on the first eliminated one, according to food chain. So here our objective is controlling the population of concerned insect only, not to eliminate that insect from the ecosystem. That is not required. But what about a synthetic insecticide, artificially produced insecticide that is able to kill any organism, not only the targeted one, including untargeted one also. Actually, as a farmer, our target is, what is the purpose of spraying insecticide or pesticide? To kill that one only. Okay, but here, that insecticide is a broad spectrum. Broad spectrum means able to kill all in that area. But what we need, a narrow spectrum insecticide only. Narrow means species specific. Able to kill certain number of species only, particular species only, particular individual only. For example, in a class, for example, 60 members are there. 2 or 3 members are doing mistake or doing nuisance. So as a teacher, I have to give punishment to those 2 individuals only. Okay, my activity. Okay, so my action should be specific, should be eliminated those 2 people from the class, or we have to give punishment to those 2 only. Instead of that, if all the students are given with corporal punishment or some other punishment, what is that one? That is a broad spectrum. What is the use of that one? So like that, we have to control the population of a certain number of insects only. Moreover, it is not required to eliminate that insect. So what about the importance of a biocontrol agent? It is able to control the population of concerned insect. If it is attacking cotton plant, the cotton plant with the help of so-called prototoxin, it is able to kill that insect, the insect which is attacking it. So there is one type of defense mechanism or not, self-defense mechanism. So take a cotton plant. Now, what about the mechanism of a BT toxin? That is Bacillus thuringiensis toxin produced by cotton plant. What about the mechanism of that? So the purpose of creation of BT cotton is to control, use it to control the population of caterpillar. What is that caterpillar? Larva of butterfly. So caterpillar is a larva of butterfly. So this caterpillar is able to damage. For example, if the cotton plant is not having so-called BT, what about other caterpillar? So caterpillar is able to damage leaves, targeting leaves, able to damage, caterpillar is able to damage leaves and particularly fruits. What is that fruit? In cotton plant, in cotton plant, the fruit is a capsule, that is a loculicidal sinusoidal capsule. This is one type of root. Sidal means a dehiscence. Plane of dehiscence is through the locule. Just remember that word, loculicidal capsule. In the textbook, this is given as, that is a cotton ball or cotton capsule, cotton balls. Cotton ball was given. It looks like a ball or not. That is actually loculicidal capsule. Inside that, cotton is present. What is that cotton? The cotton is one type of fiber produced from seed coats, emerged from seed or not. So this caterpillar is able to damage cotton balls, capsules, drilling the capsule. If you observe the diagram, for example, this is a cotton ball. Here and there, holes are there. So once that is subjected to drilling, what about the maturity of the cotton? There will be no maturity of the cotton. Then what about the yield of the cotton will be reduced. So what we did, we inserted a cry gene, which is able to control that caterpillar. What about the mechanism of action of so-called BT toxin produced in the cotton plant? For example, this is a cotton plant. It's a cotton plant. Cotton plant, just dummy diagram. Cotton plant. So inside the cotton plant, in the genome of that one, cry gene is present. Cry gene. Right? So that cry gene codes for cry protein. Cry protein. Initially, what about the state of matter of that cry protein? That is a crystal, solid. Crystal prototoxin. Okay, so that crystal prototoxin is present in leaf or a cotton ball. So for example, dummy diagram. This is a cotton ball, cotton capsule. So this is a cotton fruit. So inside that fruit, already prototoxin is present. So now caterpillar, for example, this is a caterpillar. Invertebrate. Caterpillar. Number of trichomes hairs are present. So once some part of a so-called cotton fruit or leaf entered into that one. So cotton part, some part of cotton consumed by it. So cotton capsule part is here. So now that part is with prototoxin. In the body of that one, what about a digestive tract? From here to here, mouth to anus, this region is a for gut. Gut means a digestive tract. Okay, front part. Last means anterior part, posterior part. This one is hind gut, back part, rear part. Hind gut. Gut is nothing but a digestive tract. Digestive tract that starts from mouth, ends with anus. Ends with anus or not? And this region is this major part. This part, middle part, is med gut. Once it is injected into midgut, now it is in midgut. Midgut. In midgut, the pH is alkaline pH. The pH is alkaline pH. So this alkaline pH is able to convert a prototoxin, now prototoxin convert into a toxin, potential toxin. So crystal, solid is convert into, yes, solid convert into liquid phase. Solid part convert into liquid phase. So once it is solubilized at alkaline pH, now that toxin is a very effective toxin. Now this toxin, what about the role of the toxin there in the midgut? So look at here, in midgut region, midgut means middle part of a digestive system. That potential toxin, which is in liquid phase, potential toxin in liquid phase. Now it is able to drill porous, making holes, drilling or putting holes in epithelial cells. What is a epithelial tissue or a cell? Epithelial cells. So here epithelial tissue is present, that is concerned with absorption of food materials. Absorption after digestion, the epithelial tissue is able to absorb nutrients. Okay, so they are putting holes in the epithelial cell. Once holes are established, that leads to what? Swelling of concerned cells. And that leads to what? Complete damage of epithelial tissue and death of that caterpillar. Okay, see, once some part of a cotton fruit or leaf entered into the foregut, means a mouth part. So in that mouth part, there is no conversion of a so-called solid protein into liquid. So such a thing is happening, means the conversion of a solid crystal protein into a liquid protein, prototoxin into effective toxin in the midgut part. Reason, within the midgut part, means almost a stomach region, alkaline pH is maintained. That alkaline pH is able to convert at that pH. What about the fate of that protein? Dissolves in the solvent. So converted into liquid phase. Reason, their pH is required. That pH is able to convert a so-called solid into liquid. Once it is converted into liquid phase, it is able to damage epithelial tissue present in the midgut part of a caterpillar. That leads to what? Death of the caterpillar. So here, cotton plant is not attacking caterpillar. If caterpillar attacking cotton plant, now cotton plant is able to kill that insect only, not all insects. For example, in crop 1 acre of land, 1,000 caterpillars are present. Out of 1,000 caterpillars, only 1 or 2 are attacking, growing on the plant and attacking the plant. Only those 1 or 2 which are drilling the cotton fruit and eating the cotton fruit, they will be killed. How many are there? 100 are there. How many killed? Only 2. So a biocontrol agent is the best one or not? Not causing any damage to soil, concerned plant, not entering into the food chain. Able to control the population of that insect only. Not eradicating all the caterpillars. If all caterpillars are eradicated, what about the butterfly? Is it possible to generate a next generation of butterfly? No. If butterfly population is reduced or zero, who is able to perform pollination? If you go back to ecological services, pollination, pollination services. Okay, if pollinators are absent, what about the fruit production in a plant which is dependent on the availability of concerned pollinator? There will be no fruit formation. Okay, right? So here our objective is not the eradication of all caterpillars, just controlling the population of that one only, right? So this is a biocontrol agent. Here bioinsecticide, biopesticide, both are correct, but maximum extent BT is a bioinsecticide. It is rather than a biopesticide. For example, if options are given, BT is bioinsecticide, biopesticide, first option, second option, third option something, fourth option something. Go for bioinsecticide. Okay. Fourth option, more than one is given, go for that one. If individually asked, go for bioinsecticide. It is a more bioinsecticide, less biopesticide. So most of the cryogens are insect specific only. Concerned insects only, not all. Okay, so ecologically, it is very, very important. Okay, is it clear? So that is about a biocontrol agent.